Hey everybody, I'm here at Pure Paws. I'm back at Pure Paws Vet Clinic. I'm going to be grooming Dr. Alex Schechter's dog as I normally do, but also I had a lot of questions about the ear plucking video that I did the other day. And so I'm going to be doing an interview with Dr. Stephanie Liff, where she is going to use her own dog and show you a little bit more and talk a little bit more about what that is. So stay tuned. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask Dr. Stephanie Liff to show us inside her own dog's ears a little bit what's going on and her stance on this topic. Okay, so let's look at the ear.
So Kyrie has flappy ears, which would make her prone to ear infections. And she has a little bit of hair in the canal, but if you see when you pull the hair out, it doesn't really go inside. So she's not a candidate for plucking because she doesn't have hair down in the canal, like down here. But if she was to have hair there, you can actually pluck the hair using a wax product and tweezers.
Let me get a good close up because her hair is so dark.
Yeah.
So yes, there is hair that grows inside that ear canal.
Yeah, but not so bad. So if it was dense like this, I would pluck it. But since it's a little bit thinner and she doesn't really get ear infections, even though she's floppy, I don't pluck her hair, but I do clean her ears. And so the way that I do that, she's very excited about this. I take an ear cleaner that has an acetic acid or vinegar base because you want something drying. And I soak a cotton ball pretty wet. And then I, in the canal, just right here, tuck the cotton ball in there. And then I use her ear to mush it around. She doesn't love it, but she tolerates it. I think mostly it just feels cold. And then I take this out. She's gonna shake.
That's a cool technique. I hadn't actually seen that before. I tend to go in and just give a nice sweep or a wipe.
I think when you drop the flap and smush, the cleaner goes down into the ear canal, and that's what you want. And then I put my finger in with a tissue, which is wrapped around my finger. And her ears are pretty clean, but I take out the excess liquid and the excess debris. She's pretty clean. But that way you're not hurting her. You're not gonna get anywhere near the eardrum with your finger, and it gets everything out. And then if she would shake, wanna shake? She's too good. But if she were to shake, the debris will be broken up by the vinegar or the acetic acid. So that's how I clean her ears.
Great, so that's typically what I tell my clients as well, is that, you know, I'm just the groomer, I'm not a veterinarian, so we don't fix what's not broken. And typically with ear plucking or pulling, we absolutely will do it if a veterinarian says it needs to be done. They need to be the one to make that decision, because sometimes it does have to do with history of infections or something like that, and they know what's going on. They have otoscopes, they've looked inside those ears. We can't do that. We're not supposed to do that. We're not supposed to do any internal medicine. That's practicing veterinary medicine. It's actually illegal. So we stay on the outsides. If we see something, we let you know and you can follow up with your vet. We always have cleaner on us, but yeah, don't fix what's not broken. And when it's done properly, you see, but you see, she doesn't even go inside digging. She's not using Q-tips. She's not digging in the ear canal. That's what we want to avoid unless further medicine needs to be done. What's one of the reasons that you would go deeper into the canal, and how would you do that?
So when there's infection, I will try to get as much debris and pus out of the ear as possible. But what I tell people at home is, like, I have a person trained to hold the dog, keep them still, keep them feeling confident. Because once you hurt them with the ear cleaning, they're gonna be so much more resistant in the future, and we don't want that. So when we have infection, we do clean the ears. Sometimes if it's really painful, we give pain medication or sedatives, because we don't want them to have a bad experience or a negative connotation with the ear cleaning.
Yeah, and that goes for plucking as well. Sometimes if you all of a sudden ask the groomer to pluck, or it's been a long time since grooming, there's a lot in there, and that's a lot to pluck at once. So that can be trauma to the ear canal, that can inflame, and then you've caused a problem that may have not been there before. Sometimes you can do it broken up or take it to the vet and they can do what they need to do it safely. And yeah, I would assume sometimes pain medication as well if they're that impacted in there.
Yeah, it really depends on the severity, but a bad ear infection is quite uncomfortable, and we manage that too.
All right, well, I wanna thank Dr. Stephanie Liff and Kyrie especially for just clearing that up and showing us, and thank you guys for watching.